Assalamu alaikum students, I'm your maths teacher from IYS schools. Hope you all good and safe at home. So today is our fourth online teaching class. So we start our education by online teaching again. Shall we start? But before starting the lecture, I will give you some instructions. Hopefully you all understand. Number one is, don't raise your hands during lecture. Ask questions at the end of the lecture. Use hands-free if you are using mobile and headphone for computer use. Number four, feed your ID and password properly with your name and class. Number five, take care of time for attending the class. Number six, home tasks should be done in your fair copy of the subject. Number seven, if there is any disconnectivity during the lecture, try to join again within 5 to 10 minutes. Number eight, don't turn on your video during lecture. And number nine is, if you have any question, then ask in chat box after the lecture ends. If you hear my voice, write yes in chat box. Students, if you hear my voice clearly, write yes in chat box. Start our fourth lesson, which is also from chapter number one and from your textbook, page number 5, 6, 7 till 9. Okay. So firstly, I want to give some review about yesterday's topic, that was working with 7 digits number. In the lesson number one and lesson number two, we learned how to work with 6-digit numbers. And in yesterday's lecture, I taught you how to learn or how to work with 7-digit number. So here you see on your screens, first of all, I want to share objectives of today's lecture. Number one is identify the place value of color digit. Number two, describe expanded form. And number three is placing the numbers in both ways, Pakistani way and international way. Now here you see review of yesterday's lesson. Yesterday, what we have learned, yesterday we have studied about how to work with 7-digit numbers or how to place 7-digit numbers in Pakistani way or in Pakistani period or international period. Here you see, yesterday I taught you that the largest 6-digit number is 9,99,999. When you add 1 in 9,99,999, here comes 10 lakhs. So the 7-digit number is 10 lakhs. In Pakistani period, 7-digit number or seven digit read as 10 lakhs, but in international period, 7-digit read as million. Okay, in Pakistani period, starting from the right, units, tens, hundred, ones group, then we put comma, thousand, 10,000, another group, then we put comma, lakhs, then 10 lakhs. In Pakistani way, 7-digit number read as 10 lakhs. And international way, again starting from the right side, same as in Pakistani period, units, tens, hundreds, one group is complete, it's of ones group. These three places, units, tens, hundred, comes in the group of ones. Once first group is completed here, then international way, thousand, 10,000, and 100,000. Because international way, we make group like 3, 3, and 3. And the 7-digit in international period read as million. Okay? Now, move to the next slide. So, here you see, yesterday, in yesterday's slides, I will show you some other examples. So, here are other examples. And these examples are taken from your book. You will also look into your book, page number 6 and page number 7. These slides are taken from page number 6 and page number 7 from your textbook. So, here you see example number 1. This chart represents Pakistani place value chart. All you know very well that in Pakistani place value chart, when we are working for with 7-digit numbers in Pakistani period, the 7-digit number read as 10 lakhs. Here what they say, write the number 78, 78, 36, 542. How you read it? 78,36,542 in the place value chart in Pakistani way. And also write the number in words and in expanded form. So what you have to do here, first of all, you will represent this number in Pakistani place value chart. I already told you that whether it is Pakistani or whether it is international, you will always start reading from right side, but always start writing from left side. Here, first of all, we have to represent these number in Pakistani place value chart. So, for your understanding, I'm starting from reading from right side. So, you all know that in Pakistani place value chart, we make groups like 3, 2, 2. First group is of units. Units consist of three places. For starting from the right, first one is units, then tens, then 100. These three places comes in the group of units. Here first group is completed. And you know very well that here comma act as separation. In these digits here you see, when first group is completed, you will put comma, then other group is completed, then you put comma again. Here the comma act as separation. So, now we are going to represent this number in Pakistani place value chart. Starting from the right side, 2 comes the place of unit, 4 comes under the place of tens, and 5 comes under the place of 100. Here, first group is completed. Here you see comma. Okay. Then move to the next. 6 comes under the place of 1000, and 3 comes under the place of 10,000. Here another group is complete. So 1000 and 10,000 comes under the group of 1000. Here 1000 consists of two places, 1000 and 10,000. Another group is complete here. So we put comma. Here you see. Now first, second, third, fourth, fifth. Here you see 6-digit. Now 6-digit in Pakistani place value chart read as lakhs, or it comes under the place of lakhs. Here the place of 8 is lakhs, and here is the 7-digit. All you know that in Pakistani place value chart, 7-digit read as 10 lakhs, or it comes under the place of 10 lakhs. So now, here you represent this number in Pakistani place value chart. Now look at here, how we say that 7 and 8 both comes in the group of lakhs. So you will write read it like 78 lakhs. Then first group is complete here. Then we put comma. Then 3, 10,000, and 6,000. Both the 1000 and 10,000 comes in the group of 1000. So whenever we write in words, you will merge them in single group, and we read it in only single group. So here 36,000, because 3 and 6 comes in the group of 1000. Now move to the next. Here another group is complete. So we put comma here. Now 542. These three numbers comes in the group of units, 100, tens, and units. In this way, you will write in like in words. Okay. Hope you all understood this. Now, how to represent these numbers, or how to make it expanded form. Now look at here, starting from the left side, the first digit, starting, if we starting from the right side, it was 7-digit, but if we starting from left side, it was first digit. So here, 7 stands for 70 lakhs, or it will write like this. How many zeros are there in lakh? Only 5 zeros. But when it comes to 10 lakh, you all know very well that in 10 lakh, 6 zeros are represented here with 7, so it will become 70 lakh. Okay, now come to the next. 8 stands for 8 lakhs. You all know that how many zeros are there in 8 lakhs? 5 zeros. So you will write 5 zeros with 8. Now 3 stands for 10,000. Here you represent 3 in the place of 10,000. Now 6 stands for 1000. Here you see 6 at the place of 1000, and you all know that you will place 3 zeros when we write in 1000, because total digits in 1000 that comes are 4. So here 6 is given here, so you will write 3 more zeros to make it 6000. Now 5 stands for 100. You will write like 500. Then 4 comes in the place of 10. You all know that there is only one zero in the 10 space, so you will write it like 40, or 4 stands for 40. Now the last one is unit. Then here 2 represents at the place of units. Here the number that is given here, you also see here. Now you will do expanded form. So starting from here, you will write digits taken from here, and this is the expanded form of this number. Same in the international way. What's the difference here? Only the difference is that it's in Pakistani period, 7-digit read as 10 lakh, and international way, 7-digit read as million. Only that's the difference here. Here's the difference, that in Pakistani way, 100,000 read as lakh, but here, lakh read as 100,000. Okay? Hope you all understand this. Now I am moving to today's lecture. Yesterday we have done exercise 1.2 part A and B. If you face any difficulty while solving these parts, you will ask me in and after today's lecture ends. Okay? So question number, exercise 1.2 part C. Also look into your books, page number 8. In your books, page number 8, and here you see on your screens, write these numbers and figures, placing the commas correctly according to international periods. Okay. You have to write, then the given numbers are in words. You will write in like figures that match this number. So number 1, 2,900,005,384. Here you identify, if million is given, then you easily identify that we talk about international period, because in Pakistani way, 7-digit for 10 lakh read as 10 lakh, and international period or international way, 7-digit read as million. So here you identify that here we convert, or here we use digits that represent international way. So how you write it? Here you see on next slide, number 1. 2,905,384. First of all, you would write 2, then put comma, then 905,000. 9 considered as 100,000, and 5,000 means 0 comes at the place of 10,000, 5 comes at the place of 1,000. In this way, you will write the complete the group of 1,000 that consists of 1,000, 10,000, and 100,000. Okay, so 9 is at the place of 100,000, because here 100 is mentioned with 9. So 9 comes at the place of 100,000. There is nothing given at the place of 10,000. So you will write 0 here, and 5 given at the place of 1,000. So you will write 5 here. Then we put comma. Then 300, you will write 3 at the place of 184. It means 8 at the place of tens and 4 at the place of unit. Now you will read it like 2,905,384. Units, 100s, then we put comma, 1,000, 10,000, and 100,000, because here million is given. Here you identify that here they are asking about international period. If 10 lakh is given, or here given 22 lakhs, then you identify easily that this is Pakistani way, but here million is given, and you all know very well that in international place where you chart 7-digit read as million. Okay, so here you see the change, how to change write in figures or write in numbers. Now question number 3, it's same as international way. Here you see, and this is international period. Here you change in international period, and yesterday you change in Pakistani period. Now another is 6,470,317. So this is also international period, because million is given here. In yesterday's exercise, we will convert it into Pakistani period by using 10 lakhs or lakhs and 10 lakhs, because in Pakistani place value chart, 7 digit is read as lakh. But here on, in part C, they are asking about that you just write numbers in figures in international period. So here you see millions here. Okay. So here number 4, 5,908,620. So 5 comes at the place of a million, then comma, 908,000. Here you see 900 means 900,000. So 9 comes at the place of 100,000 and 8,000. So here is mistake. Okay, you will write in correct manner. So there is already no unit, no digit given at the place of 1,000, sorry, 10,000. So here you will put 0 and here you will put 8. Okay. And then comma, then 620. Then 6 comes at the place of 600. 6 comes at the place of 100. And 2 comes at the place of 10. And 0 comes at the place of unit. Now, hope you all understand how to make these figures international periods. Then here we move to the next slide, that is part D of exercise 1.2. What they are said here, write the place value of colored digits first in Pakistani way, second in international way. This is same part as given in exercise 1.1, and can be while we working with 6-digit numbers. What's the difference here? Here is just we working with 7-digit numbers. The method is same in both here and there. So place value of colored digit first in Pakistani way, then in international way. This exercise or this type of exercise is already done by you in previous exercise in previous parts. So here you see, I've solved one question for you. That is question number 1. So here 9 is colored digit. Start reading from the right side. Units, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh. When we read in Pakistani way, here 6-digit number read as lakh and 7-digit as 10 lakh. So first of all, we have to convert it. We have to write the place value of colored digit in Pakistani way. So this is PP means Pakistani period is equal to 9 comes at the place of lakh. So we'll write 9 lakhs, or how many zeros are there in lakhs? 5 zeros. So you will write like this, 9 lakhs. But when we start reading in international period, starting from the right side, units, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, then million. In international period is a 6-digit number read as 100,000. In Pakistani period, 6-digit number read as lakhs. So here, now we convert into international period. So 9 comes at the place of 100,000. Okay, so international period is equal to 900,000, or you know very well that how many zeros are there in 100,000? 5 zeros. So 900,000 or 900,000. Hope you all understood this exercise. If you have any question regarding this part, then you will ask me in the and in chat box. Okay, same as look at question number 4. First in Pakistani period, unit, tens, 100,000. So what's the place value of 4 here? 1,000. So you write it like 4,000 first in words and then in figures. Same in international way, units, tens, 100,000. Here both the places of 4 digits read as same, both in Pakistani way and both in international way. Okay, here next question you will see here, question number 11. Starting from the right side, units, tens, 100,000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs. If you read the 7-digit in Pakistani way, then you will read in 7-digit in Pakistani way read as 10 lakhs. So here the place value of 9 is 10 lakhs. First of all, you will write 10 lakh in words, 10 in figures. But when you start read in international way, units, tens, 100, units, stands, 100, 1,000, 10,000, 100,000, and million. In international way, 7-digit will read as million and write. First of all, you will write 9 million in words, then in figures. Hope you all understand this. if you have any question regarding this part, then you will ask me in the end or after the lecture ends. Here we move to the next part, that is part number E, and the last exercise of chapter number 1. What they said here, write the numbers that match these expanded form. So first of all, you will identify, you will look here and identify whether it's Pakistani or whether it's international. Here by seeing these commas, you will easily identify that in Pakistani way, they group digits like 3, 2, 2. So this is given in Pakistani way. So 30 lakhs, 50,000, sorry, 5,10,000, 40,000, 2,580 and 7. How you match these numbers by using this expanded form, starting from here, 3 and 5. 30, 10 lakhs and 5 lakhs here, okay? So, 30, 10 lakhs means 3 comes at the place of 10 lakhs and 5 comes at the place of lakh. Here, first group is complete, we will put comma. Then, 40, 10,000 and 2,000 means 40 comes at the place of 10,000 and 2 comes at the place of 1,000. Another group is complete. Here you see 42. Then 5 at the place 500 means 5 at the place of 100. 80 means 8 at the place of 10s and 7 at the place of 100s. This is the number form of this expanded form. Okay. Now here you see the placing of commas. This shows that this expanded form is represent the international way. So here this figure count as 6 millions. Here you write 6 because 6 comes under the place of millions. Then we put comma. Then here this read as 100,000, 10,000 and 1,000. Okay, here you see in question number 2, 6 comes at the place of millions, 100,000, 10,000 and 1,000. 7 comes at the place of 100,000, 3 comes at the place of 10,000 and 5 comes at the place of 1,000. Another group is completed here, we put comma. Then 6 comes at the place of 100, 5 comes at the place of 10s and 3 comes at the place of 100. In this way, you will solve this exercise. Okay. Here you see 2 more questions are solved for you. Now, by seeing the placing of commas, you will identify whether it's Pakistani or whether it's international. So it's Pakistani because it groups in 3, 2, 2. This is international because it groups in 3, 3, 3. So here you see. 7 comes at the place of 10 lakhs, 2 comes at the place of lakhs. Here, first group is complete, you will put comma. Then 5 comes at the place of 10,000, 2 comes at the place of 1,000. So here you see 72 lakhs, 52,639. In this way, you will solve this exercise. Now, I'm sharing home task. Part C. In exercise 1.2, part C in your book, because here is space is given and you just only write it in numbers. So when you solve this exercise in your book, please use pencils, don't use pen in your books. Okay. Now part D in your fair copy by using pen, and part E also in your book because there is much space given for solving that part. Is that clear to everyone? So our today's lecture ends now and our chapter ends too. So if you have any question regarding whole chapter or regarding today's lecture, if you faced any difficulty in solving yesterday's previous exercises or today's exercises, ask me in chat.